I can't wait. I'm in.
Why am I going to win?
Because she's smart. Because she's the smartest member of the Congress. But the competition ain't that stiff.
We are certainly not overconfident.
We're going to start out slow and finish strong.
So I feel most inspired by the German national soccer team and the 7-1 victory that they had over Brazil yesterday. It really shows me that not only should we win, we should try to run up the score by a few touchdowns.
Well, that's a loaded question because we never said we were going to win tonight. If I was going to lose with anybody, it would be with these lovely people up here. I don't know if we can take on Tom Davis.
But I'll retweet it.
What makes us winners is that we're not going to take this that seriously. And that's what's going to help propel us.
Well, we're definitely going to win. We're the members of Congress. We're all overachievers. We're always the ones who sat in the front row of class and asked all the questions. So we're here to win.
In D.C. restaurant, did former Representative Trey Riddell of Florida agree to buy cocaine?
That would be Circa and DuPont Circle.
For the rest of the questions in this round, we're going to do something a little different. We're going to quote some of the most interesting political gaffes that we've heard from politicians over the past year, and you will have to identify the speaker who gave that gaffe.
I'll make it easy for you. None of them are current.
All right.
Is that right?
As far as you know.
Who said, describing the alternative to electing him, or you might have a farmer from Iowa who never... Members only.
Bruce Braley.
That is correct. Bruce Braley of Iowa said, a farmer from Iowa who never went to law school, serving as the next chair of the Senate Judiciary Committee.
All right, continuing on the gap theme. Who said, look at the background, look at the credentials. I mean, there's a high school graduate in this race, okay? I'm sorry. Wow, doesn't consult with his colleagues, he just goes for it.
And there was Georgia Senate candidate David Perdue knocking fellow Republican Karen Handel's credentials during the primary. Our next guest, who said of a fellow guest at a fundraiser, she also happens to be by far the best looking attorney general in the country. Members of
President Obama.
And he's right.
That's right. President Obama said that about California Attorney General Kamala Harris.
All right. Here we go, members only team. Mitch McConnell's primary challenger, Matt Bevin, got in some hot water earlier this year for attending a rally in support of legalizing this. And it's multiple choice here. A, marijuana. B, do you want to hear all the instructions? Go for it.
Cockfighting.
Cockfighting. The answer is C, cockfighting.
Vance McAllister has had an interesting year. First, he won a special election to Congress at the end of 2013. Then he became known nationally as the kissing congressman thanks to some unfortunate office security footage.
Hey, Boston.
Oh. Members only.
Yeah.
Wow. We've got a midterm election coming up this year, and as many of you know, the president's party often loses seats in Congress in midterm years. Chairman Israel. But there have been two midterms since World War II where the president's party...
1998.
Did you buzz in? You buzzed in.
1998 and 2002.
Well done!
Question number eight. John Corzine, the former senator and governor from New Jersey, holds the self-funding record for one Senate campaign after spending over $60 million of his own dollars to get elected in 2000. Spots 2 and 3 in the self-funding record book both belong to this person. Who, press pass. That's right, Linda McMahon of Connecticut.